All right. Likutei Maharan Torah Dalet. So we are holding by Sif Gimel. After we already explained that a person elevates the Malchus, which is Midas Adin, from amongst the Goyim, and elevates it to its shir, to its root, which is Midas Rachamim, and he achieves a clear understanding, the knowledge, realization, that everything that happens to him is for his own good. Now we'll explain how a person can actually elevate the Midas Adin to Midas Rachamim. How is it done? How do you do it? Like this. Ve'i efshar la'ashiv ha'melucha la'kodesh baruch hu. It is not possible for a person to bring the melucha to Hashem. You know, ela de vidui dvor v'tamet chochum, that a person should confess whatever he did before tamet chochum. Al de zeh, and while doing this, you rectify ma'ale u'mesaker ma'ale b'chinas malchus, you rectify and you elevate the Malchus that fell because of the Averis, it fell to the realm of the Goyim. The Shoshu, you bring it to its root, you bring it back to where it comes from. The Perush, and this is the meaning of what is written, Kchuimachem Dvorim Vishuv El Hashem. You know, so Kchuimachem Dvorim, take with you Dvorim, and come to Hashem. Now, in the words Kui Machem Dvorim, take with you Dvorim, there are two things which are alluded to here. Vzeu Vidu Dvorim, that's the confession. Vidu Dvorim, you have to confess whatever it is that you've done. A person has to confess his averes before Hashem. But Dvorim also alludes to Pchinas Malchus. Also, Dvorim is in the Malchus. And a proof of that, how do we know that Dvorim is also alluding to the Malchus? As Chazal said, the Moshe said to Yeshua that he is going to lead Am Yisrael together with this Canaan. You know, before you ask them what to do. HaKadosh Baruch Hu said, I told Yeshua, whatever you want to do, you do, and if they disagree, take a stick, bang him over the head. That's what Kodesh Baruch Hu said. Kach makel, v'akel kodkodam. Bang him down. Why? Kodesh Baruch Hu said, dabar echad ledor, ve'en shne dabarim ledor. There's one speaker to a door, to a generation, and there are no speakers. There are not two speakers in the generation. There's one speaker, that's it.
Moshe Rabbeinu passed away?
Before.
That's before Rabbeinu?
Yeah. Manig echad ledor, there's one leader to the generation, not two. There's one leader. Aresha Dabar, so you see the Dabar, one speaker, somebody who speaks. We said that Dibur is the thing that professes the Ratzri of a person. How does a king rule? He says, I want you to do this, I want you to do that. You know, you pronounce a verdict, you iterate a verdict, you put it into words. So the one who speaks, whose will and rules the land, is called a dabar, a speaker, you know, a determinator, you know, the one who says what's what?
Determinator.
Yeah, determinator.
Didn't say much.
Really. What?
Didn't say much.
No, that's something else. That was something else. It's a determinator, the right. One that determines.
Yeah.
The one that's machlet, the one that's a decider. A dubber is a decider. The one who makes decision and verbalizes them. A verbalizer. No, that's dubber. That's the one who is allowed to speak on behalf of everybody else. That's the dubber. That's the mamik. So you said dvorim tzad echad, it says vidu dvorim tzad sheni, it says malchus. Malchus is dubber, is moishel, is the melech. So dvorim is the malchus. And the reason is, as we said before, that, you know, the leader, he rules by his speech. That this is how they know what he wants. This is what it says in Pasach Eliyahu in the Akdom of the Kunezor. He says, Pchinas Malchus corresponds to the Pe. Malchus Pe Karinola. The Malchus and the mouth, you know, each part of the eyes, each part of the body is the according, you know, is parallel to a different kind of sphere. And Malchus Pet, Nimtza Shadvarim, so you see the Dvarim, and Pchinas Malchus, they correspond to the Malchus. So, Kuimachem Dvarim, take with you Dvarim. On one hand, confess your Averis. On the other hand, it means take the Malchus. Veshuva Hashem, and come to Hashem and bring it back to its source. Now, when a person confesses his averus before Talmid Chacham, and the vidui has a koyach, purify the midas of Malchus. Talmid Chacham has a koyach. The Talmid Chacham has a koyach to atone for averus. When a person confesses his averus before Talmid Chacham, Talmid Chacham has the ability to atone for that person's averus, and we may give a tikkun to the malchus, you know, perfectly, and through this koyach that the Talmid Chacham has to atone his averus, as we'll speak later on about, and the Talmid Chacham has the koyach to elevate the malchus to its shayrish, to its root. This is what it says: Kuimachem dvarim. You take the dvarim, the vidu dvarim, and the malchus. Veshuva Hashem. Shezaknu v'yalu es dvarim. You'll take, you rectify and elevate the dvarim, the pchinas malchus, pchinas elokim, which is the malchus, elokim alchim mikadem, as we proved before. El Hashem, to Shem yudkei vavkei, to Shem avayim. That alludes to midas harachmi. Haynu kana, as we said in Oisbeis, that a person does, the machus will go to its root, he's able to get to this madrega that he knows that there's no difference between midas harachmi and midas hadin. They're all both for your own good. And it is said, Ba'ashem, which is midas harachmi, alel davo, be'elokim, which is midas hadin, alel davo, I will praise Hashem. In other words, through the vidui dvarim that elevates the malchus, which is Elohim, a person will know, will get to the madrega, sheyeid shekol meirosa but kulam latovos. Everything that happens to you is everything for your own good. Vidvorach al kol advarim atovah meitim. You will make a bracha on all the things that atovah meitim, even though bepoil amaisa, you know, a person needs unarah chas v'chalila no alalein v'alalecha. A person has to make, you know, dynamics, another Tova Meitim. But however, in his heart, a person should know that this is the total goodness and will receive it, will accept it, the simcha. Rabbeinu said, you know, that when HaKadosh Baruch Hu took a child by him, he says he had to force himself to be Noyeg Aveilus. He had to force himself to Noyeg Aveilus. He says, so the child is taken away from him. Who is taken away? Kodesh Baruch Hu takes away.
Who was this?
Rabbeinu says, you know, this. He says he has to force himself. Because the Torah says you have to know Gavelos. He says, a child is taken away from him. Who is taking it away? Who is taking it away? You know, I remember, you know, Rabbi Shimon Teichner, you know, from the Kiryah. So Rabbi Shimon Teichner had a son that was killed by the Asa'a to the Cheder. Yeah, the whole thing, and you got it's a mice tzaddikim to tell about. You know, so people live like these live in our generation. Reb Shimon Teichner got married, and it was delayed, and you know it was a Heilig Bocher, and he got so distressed by the fact that his shidduch was delayed that during his benedus, he quote unquote made a deal with the Kodesh Baruch Hu. You know something? Even if I don't have a child for 10 years, you know, just give me a shidduch. And he got married, and a year passes, no children. 2 years, no children. 3 years, no children. 4 years, no children. 5 years, no children. In the sixth year, he already went to Levi Yitzchak and told him, boy, did he get it. Boy, did he get it. Rabbi Yitzchak gave him the Tale of Two Cities and David Copperfield. You know, he gave him the Dickens. He just tore it to pieces. He said, that's the way you daven HaKadosh Baruch Hu. You're making deals with him? Are you crazy?
Let's make a deal.
No, what is this? Yeah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, whatever it is, the Gaman, what is this? And he said at the time, Nunu, Ruba Kichule. Most of it is like all of it. And Taka that year, she got pregnant and this child was born.
Good behavior, yeah. Time off.
Yeah, and this child was born. And one day the child was brought back from Cheder and that the bus, the van, the brought from Cheder,
got him and
ran over him and killed him. And the child that they waited for, you know, the whole thing. And Reb Shimon, how old the child was, I don't know.
Three, four,
whatever. So Reb Shimon went to the driver to console him. Because you understand,
took a life.
The driver, there's no way he gets out of it. That's it, you know.
It's
the Lekor HaChaim. So Reb Shimon went to him, to the driver, and consoled him, and said, you should know,
why?
Talked to him, so where did I find out about this story? I lived in America at the time, and I see Reb Shimon in the Smedrash, in Shoy Shabbos, on 13th Avenue over there, on 53rd and 13 over there, Shoy Shabbos. I said, Davon Imara, whatever. And he's his usual radiant self. He's happy. He's fine. And I see another person, Mendelssohn. Mendelssohn. I see him. What? No. That Mendelssohn from here.
Stop thinking about.
One of the Breslovers from over here. Choshev the guy from Nebrak. You know, one of the more, you know, serious guys. He's not a. You know, I had some little business, some this, little that, but you know, a no-nonsense guy. So I said, what are you doing here in America? He says, I came with Reb Shimon. I said, with Reb Shimon? I said, where are you coming? I said, well, you're getting here. He told me the whole story. He says, you know, and Reb Shimon was creating yeshivas and were falling apart on him, whatever it is. So he says, we all got together, decided, listen, we got to help him out. And so I came with him to America to, Reb Shimon used to stay in my house every once in a while in America, whenever he came to us. And I told him, I don't know what to tell you. What can I tell you? I just heard. So Shimon sits in my car, and he says, look, what did I want for this child? He says, I want this child to go to Cheder, and I wanted to go to Yeshiva, and I wanted to be a Talmud Chacham, and I wanted to be a Tzaddik. And then after he's done with all this, you know, when he passes away, she'll go to Gan Eden and well, the Kodesh Baruch.
He went straight.
He says, there's a Medrash, the Kodesh Baruch sits and learns Torah with all the small children, you know, the Talmud Chacham. She says, I got it already. Just, yeah. You know, whatever, I got it. Is Kolmer Roser Tevoser. Rabbeinu says that he has to force himself. He has to force himself to be knowing avails because who takes it? Kodesh Baruch Hu takes it. What's to get upset about? But the Torah says that right now he's a Dayan Ha'emes, Lo Aleinu Velo Aleichem. So a person has to make Dayan Ha'emes. But the Ma'aseh in the heart, it should. That's not only with him. You know, the Rosh Koilel in Nachlas Chen of Kirshenbaum. You know, you look at him and he's like this really mellow, easygoing guy. I don't know. I think from his 8 children, either 4 or 5 are alive. Because him and his wife, are both carriers of Tay Sachs. So you know, every one out of two kids would get Tay Sachs and die horribly. And they will live with it. They were my neighbors on Rajbam in Nebra. And his mother, who is Nachman Galinsky's sister, the daughter of Yankel Galinsky, she would go with the child, and the child is just wasting away until age 3, 4, and then they die. And they kept on having children. Because it's not every child. It's not every child. And Baruch Hashem, they have, you know, 4 or 5 children that are alive, they're married, whatever it is, and they're willing to get on and have more children, knowing full well.
Yeah, that's it. Please stop.
Okay.
Don't want to tell us right now.
This is she'odem yodea this is Anshei Rabbeinu. Okay, that's not our level, but they exist. They exist. To be continued tomorrow.